What is going on, guys? Globe here. Welcome everyone back to another Advanced Warfare video, and today we're here and we're back for another Elite Weapon video in Advanced Warfare. What we do in this series is quite simple. I basically count down the top 5 Elite Weapons in pretty much any category. If we're looking at the best, the worst, the top 5 best Elite Assault Rifles, etc. And in today's video, we're going to be looking at the worst Elite Weapons in Advanced Warfare. Now, before I say anything, the thing I will say in this video is that it's my honest opinion of myself. You guys can have your own opinion of what elite weapons you like and dislike, and personally these are elite weapons that I dislike, and some of them I've got from the community on Twitter. So starting off, the weapon that we're going to be looking at is the Melee Whale Horn. Now the reason why this elite weapon is bad, or I dislike in general, is to start off with, I actually have this weapon. Number one, the camera looks quite nice, but that's the thing that's not bad with the weapon at all. So starting off with the weapon, what it has is it has the damage going down by 2, the accuracy is going down by 1, and the handling is going up by 2. And when you look at a light machine gun, you want the damage and fire rate to go up. You don't want the damage or the handling going down. But the good thing about this weapon is the handling goes up by 3, but you don't necessarily need it for a light machine gun, because as a lot of people say, handling has got to do with the hip firing or the no scoping if you're using a sniper, and hip firing with the light machine gun basically has no effect to this gun whatsoever. So basically you are going to be getting a light machine gun that I suppose is good at hip firing, and that is about it to this weapon. But the camo does look quite nice. I see a lot of people have this, and personally I don't find this elite weapon to live up to its expectation of being an elite. Next weapon we're going to be looking at is the Bulldog Mancy. Now personally I just like this weapon as well. This was the first elite weapon I have ever gotten in Advanced Warfare. I was so happy to use this thing until I actually used it. Yes, this weapon is honestly bad in my opinion, just because it has the accuracy going up by 1, and I do believe that is a target finder on the weapon. Now I absolutely hate it how there's only one stat increase, which is the accuracy, and they give you a bloody target finder. When are you going to use that on a shotgun? I don't think ever. And that's the reason why I think it's bad, just because the stat does nothing to the weapon. Although the camo does look quite nice, this weapon is pretty much unusable. You can still use it, but I don't see the point of having an elite version of it if there's only one stat going up. So the Bulldog Mancy definitely goes on the worst elite weapon list. Moving to the next weapon, we are going to be looking at the AK-12 Finger Trap. I also have this weapon as well. As you can see, a lot of people have it as well. Some people dislike it and some people like it, and in my honest opinion I don't like it whatsoever, because I feel that this weapon is pretty much the same as the normal AK-12. So this weapon only has the handling going up by 3, and you can't put a red dot sight or anything along those lines on it. Now when I say the handling goes up by 3, once again that has to do with hip firing. Some people say when you switch weapons it also does make it faster, but handling on an assault rifle I don't think you need it too much. Although if it was a submachine gun, that would be a different story. But personally, with this weapon, you are getting the exact same thing as the AK-12. I tried it out myself to see if there was any differences with it. I will say the camo does look quite nice once again, but I gotta say, in my honest opinion, this elite is just not worth having, as there's nothing that stands out to it that much. Next elite weapon we're gonna look at is the Lynx Kingpin. A lot of people hate this with passion, and so do I. So the Lynx Kingpin comes with a parabolic microphone. When we ever need that with a sniper, I have no idea. And the damage goes down by 1, and the fire rate goes down by 1. Although the damage doesn't do anything too much to the sniper except penetration, and the fire rate on this thing, you want it up, you don't want it down. So basically this thing, you are going to get a weapon with a lower penetration, a lower fire rate, and a parabolic microphone to finish things off. Nope, I do not want this sniper, and I consider this to be one of the worst elites in the whole game. Moving over to the last weapon we're going to be looking at in today's video is going to be the HBR A3 Bare Fist. Now, a lot of people actually do like this weapon, but personally the insanity beats this weapon by a mile. So you're going to be wondering, why is this weapon on here? In my honest opinion, I've used this weapon in about 3 games and I absolutely hated everything about it. So the first thing that comes with this weapon is that there's a red dot sight attached down by 2 or 1, does not help it whatsoever, and the range going down by 1 on this weapon I suppose doesn't do anything too much, because it is an assault rifle, and I've got to say my experience with it wasn't that good. Although you guys could have your own experience with the weapon, and personally I dislike it with passion. So guys, that is going to be the video for today. I hope you have all enjoyed today's video. If you have, be sure to drop this video a like. It would be greatly appreciated and gets the content to others. So guys, thanks for watching today's video, and I'll catch you guys later. Globe out. Meanwhile.